Hello everyone, welcome to today's editorial analysis. As you know that we analyze the editorial from the Hindu as well as from the Indian Express. This is the initiative of AptiPlus and the entire initiative is powered by IceGyan. So before starting the editorial analysis, the information about the initiative, the answer writing challenge that we are running. So what you can do, the aspirants, what you can do that you can come up to the website. You will get the description link in the description section. So every day we have 3 questions in the morning. So you can post your comment, you can write your answer, and that will be, you know, what will happen that after 6 p.m. at 6 p.m. there will be model answer. So you can just match your answer, what where you are lacking and what need to be improved. Okay, so this will be a complete answer writing challenge where you will enhancing your quality of the answers. Okay, and you will be getting the feedback also. I mean, some of the best answer will be also getting the feedback. So this would be definitely good for the student who are looking forward to increase their writing skill and enhance some bit of marks in the mains examination. And we have some other mock tests also which are lined up. So you can also enroll for the mock test series. There will be 8 sectional tests including the 4 full-length tests followed by 2 essay writing tests. So this is a sort of a comprehensive test series where you can avail the benefits and enrich your preparation. So you can avail this course both online and offline. For more details, you can refer to our contact numbers mentioned below or you can refer to the website as well. So starting the today's editorial from the Hindu itself. So the first editorial, the title of the first editorial is The Bridge Across the India and Pakistan. So see, this is by Susaini Haider. She usually writes for the international relations and for the Hindu. So it talks about how the Kartarpur corridor plan, talking about basically focusing upon the Kartarpur corridor plan, so how this would, you know, enhance the relation between the bilateral relationship between the India and Pakistan. So this is on the background, this editorial is written on the background of the Pakistan PM visiting US. Abhi wo US mein, he has met Donald Trump, so uske background mein hai, India has asked not to interfere on the matter of whatever when it's come to J&K and when it's come to other internal security matters. So we are keeping our eyes check. So us concern mein ye editorial likhi gayi hai. And see, the editorial mostly focus upon how the Kartarpur would help to build a stronger relationship with Pakistan. And definitely the temple of Kartarpur is worth for both of the countries when it's come to the bilateral negotiation. It could immunize both the terror attack and other things which are going worst and between India and Pakistan. So this editorial would be important for your general studies paper 2, particularly when it's come to international relation and when it's come to the India vocal strength when it's come to the Kartarpur project. Okay, and definitely you can quote this important Kartarpur project in any of the answer which you feel like it's talking about the India and Pakistan bilateral relation. Now the second editorial which is there in the Hindu, it's talk about the flattering step in the anti-AIDS march. So basically this talk about the UN, UNAIDS program. So it's lacking the, basically talks about the lacking of the leadership. So what we'll be doing, we'll be discussing the entire editorial in depth analysis will be there. So I'll be not taking much time here because we'll be discussing in details. So now moving ahead with the editorial from the Hindu, from the Indian Express, basically precisely from the Indian Express. So it talks about the change of the triangle. So this is again, you can correlate that editorial with this, where it also talks about the India-Pakistan relation and how we can enhance the bilateral relationship with Pakistan. Now the second editorial which is there in the Indian Express talks about, so this you can also relate with the GS paper to talking about the international relation. Okay, now coming to paper the editorial which is next in there, that talks about the new caste. So this is written on the background of the D. Raja being appointed as the Secretary General of the CPI. He has been appointed as the Secretary General of the CPI, and the editorial analysis says that D. Raja, being belonging to the Dalit community, has been highlighted, has been given a chance to represent party. Okay, so he has given a picture how this lesson can be learned from the other national party like BJP and the National Congress. So this is on the background of the leadership quality. You can read it, but again, date not important for you. You might skip it, but you can just have a look on it. Now the editorial from the Hindu talks about how not to educate India. This is on the background of NISED national draft policy. So I'll not get into the detail because we have already discussed the national draft policy, the critics, the consequences of it. So you can refer to that editorial you'll get in the our APT Plus channel. So this talks about this, and it talks about how that, you know, the draft policy has undermined the importance of English as a language. So you can also read, you may extract some of the important point. This could be important for your general studies paper 3 precisely. Okay, when it talks about the education, issues from the education emerging from the perspective of education as such. So this could be from that part. Now this other editorial which is there in the Indian Express is cricketer in the arms. This is again not that important for your examination as such. So I would rather tell you not to read this. You can definitely skip this. Now what we'll be doing, we'll be discussing our in-depth analysis on the flattering steps in the anti-AIDS march. So basically, this is written by J.V.R. Prasad Rao. He's a former health secretary of the government of India, and the views are his personal, he has expressed a personal view. So he talks about how the joint UN program, which is there, I mean joint UN program on the AIDS, so how it's lacking the leadership as such, and what are the challenges that are lying, I mean the targets which are being set, so how it is coming across the same. So we'll be discussing the detail. So let's get started with the content of the editorial. So it talks about, see, the joint UN program is, you know, commonly known as UNAIDS, is facing worst challenges of the leadership. For time being, it is facing the worst challenges of the leadership at the global, because you know these are affecting the global AIDS response. What is basically there, the question of relevance of UNAIDS is into question. Why? Because there is the leadership, I mean the director, the executive director is no more, I mean he has just about to appoint, and the working of the UNAIDS which is there, so it has not substantially come with the, you know, very progressive results. So the other question which is also being highlighted in the editorial is the United General Secretary is expected to appoint the new executive director after the departure of Michel Sidibé in May 2019. Unke hatne ke baad abhi koshish hai ki hum ek dusre executive general ko bhi appoint kare. So this is again these all wholesome contribute to the one major problem. Now talking about the UNAIDS, what exactly is UNAIDS, because this is not been discussed in the editorial. So before starting about discussing about the UNAIDS, I would just give a brief idea of what is UNAIDS. See, UNAIDS was established in 1984, okay, and it is a leading effort to end AIDS as a public health threat, okay, as a public health threat by 2030, and this is the sustainable good development goal. This is the sustainable development goal where it talks about the public health threat, and we need to reduce, we need to end it by 2030. So this is a joint UN nation program on HIV and AIDS, okay, and its main advocate for accelerated, comprehensive and coordinated goal to action against the AIDS as a pandemic. Fine. And the UNAIDS is headquartered at Geneva. This can be important for people who are preparing for other state pieces and other examination. So it is headquartered at Geneva, and it is a member of United Nations Development Group. These are the UNAIDS is the member of the United Nations Development Group. So briefly, you'll get about idea from this picture. This is the official logo of the UNAIDS, where these are the member. You can definitely have a look. These are the member. No, these are the associate partners basically. So this would be the associate partner. It is a joint nation program for AIDS and HIV. Now getting into the details, what is the mission of UNAIDS? See, basically the mission is to strengthen and to support the expansion response of the AIDS. Okay, it needs to strengthen and support the, you know, expanded response of HIV, human virus. So it talks about how, what is the mission. So it talks about prevention and transmission of HIV. So how we can prevent and transmit the HIV, how we can stop the transmission of HIV. Now talking precisely, the other mission is to provide care and support to those who are already in the virus. Jo log already virus se grasit hain, how we can provide them a care and support. Now reducing the vulnerability of the individual, how we can reduce the vulnerability of the individual, that is also one of the mission of the UNAIDS. Now talking about the communities to the HIV and elevation of the impact is also named. So these are the four important mission of the UNAIDS. Now UNAIDS also seeks to prevent HIV AIDS endemic from the beginning of the, agar wo usse bada ho jaye, before it become severe pandemic, it prevents uska jo koshish hoti hai ki first instance mein we should stop that disease to be becoming as a pandemic. Okay, so to prevent it, it also acts as a mechanism for prevention measures. Fine, so this is the mission of the UNAIDS. Not talking about the what are the five major goal of the UNAIDS. See, I'm discussing this because this would be important for you. You'd never know how the question can come. So you need to understand what is the goal and what is the mission of the UNAIDS. Now talking about the goal, the five goals, the first is to advocate leadership for effective action pandemic. Okay, effective leadership is there. Now the second is the civic society engagement with the development of strategic partners. Okay, engagement with the civil society. Now the third is the mobilization of resource to support the effective response. Okay, mobilization is resource is also one of the goal. Now tracking, monitoring and evaluation of the pandemic with response to it, how we can track, how we can monitor, how we can evaluate the pandemic of AIDS which is spreading. So this is also one of the goals of UNAIDS. Now the last would be is to strategic information and technical supports to guide AIDS against the worldwide. So these are the major goals of the UNAIDS. Now what is the HIV AIDS situation in India? Talking about these data are from 2016, and I would like to inform the student that you have raised the question that these data we can use in examination or not. Definitely you can use this, because whatever is being taught in this editorial session, is this in this session, lecture session, these are taken utmost care and they are taken from the credible source. So these are from the official source of UNAIDS India page. Okay, so you can refer it, and you have also asked us in the comment key, sir, we can use it or not. These are credible information, definitely you can use it. And the question was raised also about the Twitter, which I have there in the editorial bond, which were also there, and the users of the data users in India about the Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. So that usually varies. अगर उसके बारे में आप पूछोगे तो वो data थोड़ा vary कर सकता है, जो मैंने उस editorial में बनाया था. तो आप लोगों ने question पूछा है कि क्या हम उसको use कर सकते हैं, तो वो एक बार को different है, ठीक है, वो वाले में आप देख लेना. पर यहाँ के लिए ये जो datas हैं talking about the HIV and AIDS, these are the factual datas of 2016, आप इसको use कर सकते हो, ठीक है. Now in India, like we have 80,000 new infection which has been reported, and 62,000 AIDS has been related to that. Itne logo ka death ho chuka hai because of AIDS. Now there are like this much people who are living in AIDS with India. As these data, mind you, these data are from 2016. If you write in the examination, do quote according to the 2016. Okay, and 49% were escalating antivirus level therapy. इतने लोग जो HIV से ग्रस्त हैं, who are among the 49% were accessing to AT antiretroviral therapy. तो ये antiretroviral therapy से भी कई इतने percent लोग 49% लोग access कर रहे हैं इस चीजों को. We'll discuss more into that. So what is the key population that is mostly affected by HIV? अगर मैं इंडिया की, these data are from for precisely for the India. Okay. This data is precisely from the India. So the sex worker with HIV prevalence is like 2.2%. Okay, now when talks about the gay men and other men who have sex with the men, so this is like prevalence of 4.3%. Now the people who inject drugs, so there the HIV prevalence is somewhere 9.9%, and the transgender people with the HIV prevalence has 7.2%. These data are authentic. If you want, you can directly use in this examination. And to just understand a piece of information, you can also get the whatever we are teaching here, whatever we are learning, you can get the notes of it in the description of this video, so you can refer that as well. So this would be very important for you. Now what are the scenario exactly? Talking about the 2010, the new HIV cases has been decreasing. It has been decreasing 46% by, okay, and the AIDS related death has also been decreased by 22%. This is also an important point for your examination. Now to advance the fast track targets and eliminate mother to trial transition HIV surface by 2020, ye bhi hamara target hai ki hum is cheez ko ye hame reduce karna hai. So this has been well articulated in 2017 national health policy. You can also quote this ki government of India has on national health policy 2017, they have focusing upon eliminating mother to child transmission of HIV and syphilis by 2020. Okay, now the other is like the scale up of the recent finalized national strategy plan of 2070 to 2044. Isme bhi hum isko scale up kar sakte hain. That is also a task to be seen. Now moving ahead, somewhere like 22 million people around the world are using almost no antiretroviral therapy, that is called ART. So this much of the people are using it, even or preventing mother to child transmission has become an achievable goal by 2020. Yeah, this would be an achievable goal for across the world ki hum is cheez ko achieve kar sakte hain in consideration to India as well. Now talking the other organization that has provided, no, the organization talking about the UNAIDS. The UNAIDS. So the organization has provided the leadership to many countries in 10 years. Okay, it has provided the leadership to many countries that could hold the epidemic reverse on the trend. So unhone kaam kiya acha, but abhi leadership ki issues jo hai wo kafi badi ubhar ke aayi hai. Now talking about the what are the concern when it talks about the UNAIDS, what are the concern that has been raised in this editorial particularly. So it talks about the consequences of weak leadership. Ho kya raha hai ki their suggestion are like ki agar aisa agar weak raha to it should be shifted back to the WHO jahan se originally it was evolved, jahan se originally wo bana tha 25 saal pehle 26 saal pehle almost. तो इट टॉक्स अबाउट कि क्या हम इसे वापस WHO के साथ मिला दें, बिकॉज लीडरशिप अच्छी नहीं हो पा रही है, द टारगेटेड विच आर बीइंग सेट इज नॉट बीइंग अचीव्ड. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द मेजर कंसर्न दैट इज बीइंग फोकसिंग ऑन दिस एडिटोरियल. नाउ द सेकेंड टॉक इज लाइक एपिडेमिक, विद द एपिडेमिक विच इज स्टिल देयर इज स्टिल अलाइव. ओके, हाउएवर वी शुड कम विद नो रिड्यूसिंग इट, बट द सब्सटैंशियल रिजल्ट, द प्रोग्रेसिव रिजल्ट इज नॉट सीन. Now talking about the thinking that the AIDS epidemic can simply be treated by the way of saturation of ART or ARV, antiretroviral therapy or coverage, will not be sufficing the need for the R. Definitely we need to think beyond it, we need to work on the preventive measure, we need to work upon the ground level as such. So these are the some of the concern, and the other important concern would be to weakening of the country leadership of the UNAIDS in many of the high prevalence countries. Okay, I'm just leadership is also one of the biggest cause of the concern, and the biggest setback would be the lost voice of the vulnerable communities. The vulnerable communities are also not adequately represented or not been adequately policyized. Unke liye, we need to target for the vulnerable people as well. We need to segregate, we need to have a special policy for them. So lost voice kahin na kahin unke liye bhi cheeze ubhar ke nahi aa rahi hai. They are being neglected, they have been lost voice for that. Now talking about the question of the relevance of UNAIDS is a global response. ये बातें उभर के आ रही है कि what would be the relevance of UNAIDS if the parameter set, if the targeted set are not actually met. Okay, because we have SDG goal also which are lined up for 2030. ठीक है, so this is there. Now the talking the approximate 1.7 million new infection and 1 million that has been occurring every year. So this is again the severe cause of concern which we definitely need to work upon and come to a conclusive solution. So this point you can also use in the examination. Now what would be the way forward, what would be the way forward so that we could definitely come up to give a proper leadership. So now I'll be discussing what is the way forward. So the commitment to end the AIDS as a pandemic by 2030 needs strong and fearless leadership. Okay, it needs strong and fearless leadership, maintaining the autonomy and the authenticity of the organization. And talking about the new executive director should be the one. I mean, the editorial also talks about how we are not the UN is planning to execute the appoint a new executive director. So the role of the executive director, whoever the new director would be, the role would be to equip with an exit strategy to wind up the organization. Okay, so how we can equipped and the potential of the organization need to be increased, and the new executive director has to work relentlessly to pace the prevention of epidemic. Okay, a proper and holistic planning, a sustainable policy so that we can empower the communities and just reduce the ratio of the AIDS in the global arena across the world. Now talking about the commitment to the AIDS, to end the AIDS in 2030 needs an ambition, but it is not impossible. Definitely this is not impossible to achieve. We need to maintain a balance, we need to maintain the policy balance, we need to maintain the sustainability in the decision making so we could achieve this target by 2030. And definitely this would not be an impossible, this was very much possible with the organization coming, their proactive role. So this would be the way forward when it's come to the examination. You can definitely write this as a way forward. So this was there basically in the entire editorial analysis. It's a good editorial analysis. You can jot down some of the important points. For more details, you can also refer to the description of this video, where we'll be getting the details of the content, whatever we have discussed as a crisp notes. So I humbly thank you for listening and wish you all the best. If you have any problem, any doubt, just let us know. We'll be more than happy to help you. I sincerely wish you all the best. Keep your work hard done. Keep rocking.